Did you know that if you were born after 2000, during your entire life, there has been someone living in space? That's thanks to the International Space Station, which celebrated its 20th anniversary of continuous human habitation in 2020. You've probably heard a lot about the incredible science that happens on board the station, but the outside is actually prime real estate for all kinds of experiments and technology development too.
The International Space Station is a great platform to demonstrate service and technology because it provides power, data, there's robotics in space.
With Tech on Deck, we'll be talking about some key experiments that have taken place outside in the harsh environment of space, which will help us advance human exploration.
NExIS is NASA's Exploration and In-Space Services Project Division at the Goddard Space Flight Center. The goal of the division is to usher in a new era of more sustainable, affordable, and resilient spaceflight, both near the Earth, around the Moon, and deep into the solar system. Many members of the NExIS team started off with the Hubble telescope servicing missions. We've taken that technology, applied that to robotic servicing.
From robotic refueling missions that will help spacecraft live longer and journey farther to autonomous navigation systems, NASA's Exploration and In-Space Services Division has taken advantage of the wonderful opportunity station offers to test new technologies. As we look to exploring our solar system and beyond, and establishing a sustained human presence in space beyond low Earth orbit, many of these technologies will play a key role.
We use the robots and space station to demonstrate the technologies needed to enable satellite servicing in the future. We've also used the robots and space station to do some of the more repetitive tasks or the dangerous tasks that astronauts shouldn't be doing, like going outside the space station to try to look for ammonia leaks. Robots are very good at moving fine, delicate positions, moving back and forth, doing those sorts of tasks that would be challenging for humans to do.
In order to live in space, astronauts will first need to reach their far-out destinations like Mars. This will require refueling and replenishment of oxygen supplies, things the robotic refueling missions worked to demonstrate on station. They will also need to be able to construct, maintain, and repair their habitats, as well as adapt to unforeseen circumstances.
Because we're in space and low Earth orbit, we have lighting conditions that are representative of objects in space, and so allows us to launch tools and modules into orbit, put them on the space station, and then use those robotic technologies and all the infrastructure that comes with the space station to mature those technologies in a way that's much, much less expensive than if we try to launch our own satellite and demonstrate those for the first time not using the space station.
For these endeavors, NExIS's work with astronaut tools, satellite servicing, and on-orbit assembly and manufacturing will do the trick.
We develop the technologies that are needed to advance exploration in ways you can service satellites in the future, build satellites and build structures on orbit, refuel satellites on the way to other planets, repair those satellites, much like we do on the outside of space station. Both humans and robots are used to maintain habitats in space. We're developing technologies that can be used by NASA and others to make those a reality.
The International Space Station is the perfect testing ground for technologies that will be used to propel humans farther than we've ever gone before. The station is helping us build the necessary foundation to make it possible.